Hello, and welcome to another episode of Little Nightmares with Retro Phoenix 80. In this episode, we are going to take on the Geisha. I think I pronounced that right. There is some downloadable content now for this game, which actually I'm very excited about, but at this point in time, I'm just going to focus on the main game. So let's see what kind of trouble we can get into. Now, since this is the last section, I don't know if I'm going to be dividing this one into a section, making this the final episode, or if I will divide the recording into a couple of episodes. Or if I rage quit like a little baby. Broken mirror. It's got to be ever vigilant, ever always aware. Okay, we got a locked door, so that means we're on the mission to find a key. I hear singing. Do I? Well, I do. Dear. Like, oh shit, I was in trouble. I'm a little nervous, folks. Don't know what to expect out of this. It's strange that some of the pictures Richard has been covered. I was just trying to figure out where the hell she went. Alright, the geisha is gone. The geisha, whatever. Worth a shot. Oh. I wonder if there's not something more sinister going on here. Well, so maybe if the clue to who Six really is. Alright, so I'm not entirely sure what to do here, folks. Thank you. I have a feeling this could get really dangerous really quick. But it's been quiet. Too quiet. See? Told you. Got a little too dangerous. It's just that my controller veered. I know that there were a few of you who thought that I should have had some kind of reaction in the last video to the 2-6 getting eaten by those nasty people. And yes, in my mind I did have a reaction, but it didn't translate to my face. I was like, oh my god. But I was sitting there like, who in the hell can come up with shit like that? They still call this a good game. And it is a good game. It's just got some really weird points to it that are, I don't know how to explain. Almost sickening. And if these are the real nightmares of the creator, the developer of this game, bravo, sir. This has seriously got some disturbing stuff in it. There she is. I Uh-oh. Well, it has something to do with the mirror. Thought it had something to do with that. I'm back. Turns out I already had it figured out. Just mirroring something. You gotta run. As long as I stay in the light, aim that mirror at her, she's toast.
here. That little pig, the vampire. Or a soul sucker.
Apparently that's the game. Honestly, I had no idea about this game going into it. It was pure interest. Recommended to me by a girl at GameStop in Henderson. I went ahead and bought it. I was like, this thing should be interesting. Because, you know, I love puzzle games. I'm glad I bought it, honestly. This game is interesting, to say the least. I don't know what else to call it. It's definitely dark. You gotta go into it with an open mind, otherwise you're just gonna end up throwing it out the window and regretting your choice to purchase. I would highly recommend it, honestly. If you can get past the disturbing parts, I would highly recommend playing it at least once. As far as downloadable content, I am going to go ahead and attempt to purchase it and or download it if I can free and see what comes with the next chapter. And then go big, go all out, right? Well, that will conclude the main game of Little Nightmares. I'm just waiting to see if there's some kind of a surprise at the end of the credits, like, you know, they do with movies. I was honestly thinking that this last part was going to take a lot longer than it did, mainly because, you know, all the shit you had to go through to get there, I didn't expect it to just end, you know? This is kind of what we got. Let's see if I can speed this up a little bit. And there you have it, folks. That is the end of Little Nightmares. And also the end of this episode. Subscribe for more content. And as always, I will see you in the next video. Later.